Thank you for joining us today. We are going to be praying, and I have certain ways that I like to pray. One of the most powerful ways that I'm going to pray, that we'll pray today, is pray through scripture. And I'll give you a little teaching on that at the end of this, but let's go forth before the Lord, and I'm going to be reading some scriptures as we go through this. And just pray on behalf of the Lord for some things that are going on. And just want to, you know, add to your arsenal today. And I'll talk a little bit about that at the end. Father, we thank you, Lord, for this day. We thank you, Lord, that we are living in a time where there are many needs. There are many things that are going on, Father. And I know that with healing is a very, very important part of people's lives right now. A lot of people that are sick, they're struggling from different aspects of life. So Lord, I do lift up those people today, Lord, and I pray. It says in your word, he took up our pain and bore our suffering. Yeah, we consider him punished by God, stricken by him and afflicted, but he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him, and by his wounds we are healed. The first part of that, Lord, speaks about physical healing. And I ask, Lord, that those on my prayer list today, Lord, and Father, I'm praying on behalf of the people that I've come in contact with over the years, Lord. All those people, Lord, who I have been able to talk to or spend time with, from maybe someone I maybe talked to for 30 seconds to someone who I built a relationship with. Lord, family, friends, work people, just people, Lord, who need to be touched today, Lord. Just pray, Lord, that you would touch them as well as the people that they are in contact with as well. That, Lord, we are all connected. So, Lord, I pray physical healing on that first scripture, Lord. I pray for physical healing on behalf of people today, as well as spiritual healing, Lord, that you would touch them, Father. It says, do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen and help you. I will uphold you with my right hand. So, Lord, thank you, Father, that you will touch us and that you can give us strength today, Lord. Touch those who I'm praying for today. Give them strength, Father, and I thank you for that. It says in your word, ask and it'll be given. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened for everyone who asks, receives, and the one who seeks finds, Lord. I know that in the Greek that says to continually ask and continually seek and continually knock. So, Lord, I come before you again. And I ask that you would bring healing, that you would help those that as I knock on the door today, Lord, that you would open a door that cannot be closed of healing and your hand upon those who are hurting today in Jesus' name. Truly, I say to you, whoever says to this mountain, be taken up and thrown into the sea, and does not doubt his heart, but believes what he says will come to pass, will be done. Therefore, I tell you, whatever you ask in prayer, believe that you have received it, and it'll be yours. And whenever you stand praying, forgive. If you have anything against anyone, so that your Father, who is in heaven, may forgive your trespasses. Lord, I pray that you would help me to remember to forgive, to remember to touch people's lives, Father, Lord. There are people in my life, Lord, if there's anyone, Lord, today, right now, Lord, that I might have something against, Lord, I pray that you would just remove that. Help me to forgive them in Jesus' name. And I ask, Lord, that you would move us forward so that they can have healing and that I can have healing as well. Hear me, O Lord, and I will be healed. Save me and I will be saved. For you are the one I praise. Just like the beautiful song that Don Moen sings, Lord, heal us. Heal us, Lord. Touch us in Jesus' name. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers out of them all. Lord, why my soul are you downcast? Why are you so disturbed within me? Put your hope in God, for I will yet praise him, my Savior and my God. Lord, help us to praise you, Lord, because not only with physical sickness, Lord, there's also the emotional pain and the emotional struggles and depression and things that come along with that, Lord. Help us, Father, when we are downcast physically and emotionally, Lord. Lift us up. Help us to put our trust in you today, Father, and I give you praise for that, Lord. Have mercy on me, for I am faint. Heal me, O Lord, for my bones are in agony. Psalm 6:2, Lord. That the bones, Father, are so important. We don't want our bones to be dried out, that we don't want our lives to be taken out. It's cheerful heart is good medicine, but a crushed spirit dries up the bones. So, Lord, I pray that you would lift our spirits today, Father, in Jesus' name, that you would touch us, O Lord, in this time, Father, and I thank you and praise you for that. Rejoice in the Lord. I will say it again, rejoice. Let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. Do not be anxious about anything, but through prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, make your requests be made to God, and the peace of God that transcends all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Lord, bring us peace today in these difficult times. Lord, bring us peace. Touch us with your shalom peace, Father. It says you are Yahweh Shalom. You are the God of peace. And I pray, Lord, that you would bring us peace no matter what may be coming against us. For those on my prayer list today who I've come in contact with over the years, touch them, Lord. Bring them peace. For those they've touched as well, Lord, and they've come in contact, bring them peace, Father. Open their hearts. Bring them healing today in Jesus' name. For the Spirit God gave us does not make us timid, but gives us power, love, and self-discipline. Give us all those things today, Lord, in Jesus' name. And Lord, I know that I can pray for all these people, Father, and that you can reach each and every one of them. You can touch the people that I used to work with in the nursing home. You can touch the people who I pastored over the years, Father. The people who I have come in contact with, Lord. The people on South Street, Lord, that I ministered to so many years back. That, Lord, you can touch those people in the Netherlands and Israel and Cuba. All those people, Lord, that your grasp has no end. That my prayers, Lord, are powerful when I come to you, Lord, that I don't need to just limit myself to how many people I can pray for, but I can pray for so many, Father. Thank you, Lord, for that. Thank you for healing today, Father. And I also pray against attack and ask, Lord, that you would protect us, Father, in times of attack. It says in your word, though we live in the world, we do not wage war as the world does. The weapons we fight with are not the weapons of the world. On the contrary, they have divine power to demolish strongholds. We demolish arguments and every pretension that sets itself against the knowledge of God. We take captive every thought and make it obedient to Christ. Lord, help us, Lord, in attack. Individually, as it says in that scripture, Lord, help us individually as we get attacked, Lord. Protect our mind, protect our thoughts. And Lord, as it goes out, and it's a group thing as well, that we can be attacked from a group perspective, I pray that you would protect us as well. Against every argument, every pretension, anything that sets up against what you have planned, Lord, I pray that you will tear it down and that you will bring peace and love, that you will bring your greatness and your mightiness into those things. And it says in your word, I tell you, Peter, on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not overcome it. Lord, there is a strategy right now to take out the church. Lord, just like in the late 80s, Father, that you went into Cuba and the church was dying. And you took it and you revived it. Lord, revive our churches. Keep our churches during difficult times. Protect our pastors and our congregations during these difficult times. Have your hand upon them and protect them. Have miracles take place within them, Lord. Lord, it'd be awesome if revival would take place, not only here, Lord, but throughout the world. That, Lord, you would touch the churches in a mighty way and call them to pray again. Call them to a time of prayer and desire to reach out to your presence. That we need your presence, Father, so desperately in these times. So, Lord, I pray for that. Strengthen us and protect us from the evil one. The enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus says he comes that you can have life more abundantly. I pray against the enemy and his schemes today, and I pray that you would have life, that those on my list, those that I've come into contact over the years, would have life more abundantly, that you would move in them, Father. You are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of him who brought you out of darkness into his marvelous light, Lord, that we are your priests, Lord. Help us to remember that there's so many people out there that struggle with their worth and who they are in Christ. Lord, help us to remember our identities, our true identities are in you, not in anything of this world, but we are in you, the chosen priesthood, the royal people, Lord, that you look at us and you see beauty. You look in us and see things that we don't see sometimes, because sometimes we beat ourselves up. We struggle and go through many different things, Lord. I pray, Father, that you would help us to look and to see the beauty that you see in us, so that we may see who we truly are. So many people that struggle with low self-esteem and hurt, and I pray against it in Jesus' name. No weapon formed against you shall prosper, and you will condemn every tongue that accuses you. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and this is their vindication from me, declares the Lord. There are people in this world, Lord, being used by the enemy to bring us down. I pray, Lord, that their words would not harm us, but, Lord, that we would stand firm in who you are and what you've called us to be, Father. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked advance against me to devour me, it is my enemies and my foes who will stumble and fall. Though an army besiege me, my heart will not fear. Though war break out against me, even though I will be confident, one thing I ask from the Lord, this only do I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze upon the beauty of the Lord, to seek him in his temple. For in the day of trouble, he will keep me safe in his dwelling. He will hide me in the shadow of his sacred tent and set me high upon a rock. Then my head will be exalted around the enemies who surround me. At his sacred tent, I will sacrifice with shouts of joy. I will send and make music to the Lord. Father, keep us high above. Protect us, Father, from the things of the enemy, the things that the world would try to devour us with, the things that the world would try to attack us with, Lord. Protect us. Help us to be under the shadow of your wing. Help us to be in your love and in your care, Father. Hear my voice when I call. Lord, be merciful to me and answer me. My heart says, if you seek his face, your face, Lord, I will seek. Do not hide your face from me. Do not turn your head away from me in anger. You are my helper. Do not reject or forsake my God and Savior. Though my father and mother forsake me, the Lord will receive me. Lord, thank you that you are always there to receive us. Even when we're prodigals and we run away and we get involved in all the junk that this world has to offer. Thank you, Lord, that we can always come back to your protection. that you protect us while we're out in the world and we're getting yucky and muddy and all those things that the prodigal was, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that we can always come back. And while we're out there, Lord, you're watching over us. Lord, protect those people who have walked away. There are people in our lives, Lord, who have backslidden, who have fallen away from the faith, who have walked away from the church and walked away from you. I pray, Lord, that you would keep them protected while they are out there. As the enemy would have them attacked, be attacked, and go through the storms and the horrible things that take place, Lord. I pray, Lord, that you would keep them safe and that you would bring them back to us, Lord, just like a prodigal, just like the one out of the 99. Bring them back safely to us, Father. Teach me your way, O Lord. Lead me in a straight path because of my oppressors. Do not turn me over to the desire of my foes. For false witnesses rise up against me, sprouting malicious accusations. I remain confident to this. I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord and be strong and take heart. Wait on the Lord. Sometimes we need to wait, Father. Help us to be patient, to know that we need to wait on you sometimes. That, Lord, sometimes you will come at the 11th hour. And in those times, Lord, I pray that you would help us to stand confident. Instill the confidence of your spirit within us. Help us, Lord. And this is to those who I've come in contact with over the years. Be with them, my family, my friends, loved ones, people I've worked with, my enemies that I've been in contact with. Lord, bring them to you. Bring them and their hearts. Change their hearts and their lives, Father. And I thank you for that. The Lord will watch over our coming and going, both now and forever. And Lord, it says in your word, be still and know that I am God. So in these trying times, in these struggles that we may be having, Lord, the people who I've been in contact with, who have been in contact with other people, Lord, I pray, Father, that you would help them to be still. It says in that be still, Lord, in the Hebrew, it says hands off and know that I am God. Help us to let go of the things of this world, to let go of the things that we struggle with, and to stand in you today. And Lord, I pray for building up. Build people up today, Father. Work in their lives, Father. Build us up as believers. It says in your words, arise and shine, for your light has come. And the glory of the Lord rises upon you in Isaiah 60, verse 1. Lord, rise up as we may rise up with you, Father. And I thank you for that, Lord. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the one who takes refuge in him. Thank you, Lord, for that. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust him, so that you may overflow by the power of the Holy Spirit. I thank you, Lord, that you can do that, Lord. Arise in our hearts and in our lives. Arise and build us up today, Father. And I thank you, Lord, that you can do that, Lord Jesus. It says in your word, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him. He will make your path straight. Thank you, Lord. This has been my life verse since moving to Louisiana. Help us, Lord, to trust in you. Help us, Lord, to acknowledge when you do things in our lives. And make our path straight. Touch those in my friends and family and loved ones and pastors and people, Lord, who I've been in contact with. Touch them today and make their path straight, Father. Be with them. Be on your guard. Stand firm in the faith. Be courageous and strong. Lord, help us to be courageous and strong. Only through you and your spirit can we be strong. Peter, Lord, denied you 3 times. But when he was filled with the spirit, he slept knowing he was going to die the next day. He did not struggle with anything. So, Lord, in your spirit, Father, continue to strengthen us. In your spirit, continue to move in us, Father. Be but you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wondrous light. Thank you, Lord, for pulling us out into your wondrous light, into who you are today, Father, and I thank you for that. For you formed my inward parts. You knitted me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works. My soul knows it very well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was being made in secret, intricately woven in the depths of the earth. Lord, there's somebody out there today that I've come in contact with who is not feeling who they're called to be, who is struggling with some kind of low self-esteem, some kind of issue, some kind of struggle. And I pray, Lord, that you would build those people up. Those people on my list, Lord, I pray that you would build them up, that you would make them what you've called them to be, Father, that you would help them to understand who they are in you. The word says, are not five sparrows sold for two pennies? Not one of them is forgotten before God. Why, even the hairs on your head are all numbered. Fear not, you are more valuable than any sparrow. Thank you, Lord. Show us our value. Help us to remember we are valued. There's so many people in this world that struggle with identity issues. They struggle with their identity and who they truly are. And they go all, there's hundreds and hundreds of different labels and definitions of people now. When, Lord, the reason they struggle is because they don't have their identity in you. So, Lord, I pray that you would bring them to an identity of who you are and help them to stand in you. And I thank you for that, Lord. It says in your word, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that by testing you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. Lord, conform us to your image, to what you've called us to be. Renew our minds today, Father, through your Holy Spirit. Touch our hearts. Touch my heart today and those who I've come in contact with. Renew our minds in Jesus' name. Therefore, if anyone in Christ is in Christ, they are a new creation. The new creation has come. The old has gone. The new is here. Thank you, Lord, that you've made us a new creation. Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God were pleading through us. Behold what manner of love the Father has bestowed on us, that we should be called children of God. Lord, thank you that we are your children, that you allow us to call you Abba, that you allow us to call you Dad. I thank you, Lord, for that. Help us to remember that we are your children and we have a special place in you because you are the Father. But whatever were gains to me, I now consider loss for the sake of Christ. What is more, I consider everything a loss because of the surpassing worth of knowing Christ Jesus, my Lord, for whose sake I have lost all things. I consider them garbage that I may only gain Christ and be found in him. Not having a righteousness of my own that comes from the law, but that which is through faith in Christ, the righteousness of my own that comes through the law, but that is through faith in Christ, the righteousness that comes from God on the basis of faith. Philippians 3, 7 through 9. Lord, help us to remember that this world is just falling apart. We are surrounded by the temporary. So many temporal things, Lord, in this world, but Father, that you are the eternal part. That, Lord, those around us, Father, the soul is the most important thing. Covered up by the body that is made up the same 17 elements that make up dirt. That these dirt suits have something beautiful in them. Something, Lord, it says in your word that you know, what if it to gain the whole world yet forfeit our souls? And that, Lord, that word world means universe, cosmos, Lord, that you look at the soul as being more precious than anything in the whole universe. So, Lord, I pray, Father, for those souls that I've come into contact with, that you would be with them and you would help them to bring them to an eternal thinking. Help us to understand you from an eternal aspect. Remove the temporary from our lives. Just like it says in your word to conform us and to renew our minds, I pray, Lord, that you would help us in that. And we know that all things work together for good for those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. That's especially important right now. That's especially important because of the fact that there's so many people that are struggling right now. They're going through so many different things, Father, but you will take what this whole thing is and you will make it for good. You will take the bad in all the stuff that's happening right now. And there's people that I've been in contact with over the years who are going through so much. And all the bad things that are happening to them, I know, Lord, and I stand in confidence today that you will take those bad things and you will turn them around and you will make them for good. That you will take care of them, Lord. That you will bless them. That you will give the desires of the heart and make your plans succeed, like it says in Psalm 20, verse 4. And I thank you that you can do that, that you will commit to the Lord whatever you do, and he will establish your ways. That, Lord, you will establish us in our ways as we commit it to you. Committing all these bad things that are happening, making them good. Thank you, Lord, for blessing them. For I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you, not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the one who takes refuge in him, Lord. Help us in these difficult times to take refuge in you. Help us, Father, to stand firm in who you are. And thank you, Lord, that there is blessing in that. How abundant are the good things that you have stored up to those who fear you, that you bestow in the sight of all those who take refuge in you. But to you who are listening, I say, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. Bless those who curse you. Pray for those who mistreat you. Lord, that is a difficult prayer. Pray for our enemies. Pray for those who hurt us, Lord. But Father, I know this because you revealed it to me so many years ago, that the people who are our enemies, if they know you, if you were to open their hearts, if you were to change their ways, if you were to lead them down straight paths, they would not be our enemies anymore. But Lord, I've seen some people who were my enemies become my closest friends. That Lord, you can do that when we pray for our enemies. That we pray that you bless them and that you touch their lives. What greater blessing than to have salvation? That any enemy of ours or to this country in the United States or anyone, Lord, who, if their hearts were open to Jesus, would not be our enemies anymore. That you would touch them, Lord. You could touch the leaders of Congress. You could touch those who are in high authority, dictators, anyone, Lord, who is in this world that is an enemy of you. You could change that and make them a friend. So, Lord, I pray for our enemies. I pray you bless them with their salvation, that you open their hearts and that you help them to become a part of the kingdom of God. And I thank you for that, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, that you can do that. And I give you praise. You won the cattle on 1,000 hills. And God will meet all your needs according to his riches and glory in Christ Jesus. Thank you, Lord, that you are listening, that you own the cattle on 1,000 hills. And there are many people who need help right now, who are struggling financially, who are struggling with different things. I pray, Lord, that you would take care of all their needs according to your riches and glory, that you would touch their lives. Lord, that you would make a way where there seems to be no way, Father. Do not repay evil with evil or insult with insult. On the contrary, repay evil with blessing, because to this you were called to inherit a blessing. Lord, help us. When people want to be evil towards us, help us to stand in you. Not to open our mouths and to say what we want to say, Father. Just help us with that. Whoever gives heed to instruction prospers, and blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord. Father, I trust you through this time. Lord, I have not been able to work because of the coronavirus and because of the struggles that I've been having. But I trust you in this time that you're going to take care of me. I ask that those that I've come into contact with, that they would have that same trust. That they would have that same understanding, that you would help them in these struggles and in these moments, Father. And I thank you and praise you for that. Blessed are those who keep his statutes, then seek him with all of their hearts. Help us, Lord, to do that. Help each and every one of us to follow you and to walk with you with all our hearts. Father, it's so difficult for us to do that in this world when the temporary wants to get in the way, Father. I pray, Father, that you would just help us, Lord, to seek you with all our hearts. And I thank you for that. Because you have so little faith, truly I tell you, you have faith as small as a mustard seed. You say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible for you, Lord. Thank you that nothing is impossible. That, Lord, we can come to you with any need, with any struggle, with anything that we face. And, Lord, nothing is impossible with you. You can bring us to a greatness of who you are in your mighty name. And I thank you, Lord, that in our struggles, Lord, that you can bless us. And you can help us, Lord, to become closer to you. And as we become closer, as we trust, as we grow, that you bless us, that we can bless others. And I thank you for that, Lord Jesus. If any of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously without fault, and it will be given to you. But when you ask, you must believe and not doubt. Because the one who doubts is like the waves of the sea blown and tossed by God. That person should expect to not receive anything from the Lord. Lord, help us not to doubt in your power, in your strength, even in the 11th hour, like I was praying about earlier. Those who I've come into contact over the years, the people I love, my family, my friends, help them, Lord, not to doubt. Because where faith lives, doubt dies. So I thank you, Lord, that you can build our faith and strengthen us in time of need. Record my misery. List my tears in your scroll. Are they not in your record? Lord, there are people in this time right now. They need your peace. They need your comfort. They have. And people I've come into contact with, some of them have gone, and they need your, you know, there's people who were touched by them that need your comfort. They need your peace right now. My friend, Lord, who I lost, I pray that you would bring comfort and peace to those who are connected to him. That, Lord, you would connect us as we lose, Father, that you would bring peace and comfort to our lives. Have I not commanded you, be strong and courageous? Do not be afraid, do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. May your unfailing love be my comfort, according to your promises to your servant. Lord, thank you that you will comfort us in time of need, that you will help us in time of struggle. And Lord, be with those who I've come into contact with over the years, my family, my loved ones, my friends. Touch them, Lord, in a mighty way. Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take your yoke upon me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For for my yoke is easy and my burden light. Father, there are many people on my list, people who I've come into contact with who have heavy burdens, who struggle with heavy things on their hearts and in their minds. I pray, Lord, that you would be with them and that you would help them, Lord, today in Jesus' name. Peace I leave you, peace I give you. I do not give you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled and do not be afraid. Lord, strengthen, remove, help, have us have peace and comfort in this time. I have told you these things so that in you, you may have peace. In this world, you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world. Finally, brothers and sisters, rejoice, strive for restoration, encourage one another, one mind, live in peace, and the God of love and peace will be with you. Therefore, since we have been justified through faith, we have peace in God through our Lord Jesus Christ. But the wisdom that comes from heaven is first of all peace, loving, considerate, submissive, and full of good fruit, impartial and sincere. Blessed are the peacemakers. Lord, help us to be peacemakers, not peace takers, but peacemakers, Lord. Help us to bring peace, to walk in peace, to help people to have peace and comfort, especially when they're going through difficult times. Touch those on my list today, Father. And one of the greatest things that we need to be praying for, Lord, the greatest thing and the last thing I pray for today, I pray for salvation. I ask, Lord, that you would open up the hearts of those who are not saved. The harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. Ask the Lord of the harvest to send out workers into his harvest field. Lord, there are people out there who need to get off their tails and get out there and to share the gospel with others. Lord, I pray, Father, that you would stir in the heart of the believer to be able to go out there and to tell people about the love of Jesus Christ. The reason that we're saved, Father, is because somebody shared with us. Help us to share with others and to tell them of the salvation of Jesus. And even if our gospel is veiled, it is veiled to those who are perishing. The God of this age has blinded the minds of unbelievers so they cannot see the light of the gospel, which displays the glory of Christ, who is the image of God. Lord, there's blinders over people, it says in your word, that they cannot see, that they're walking in darkness. I pray that you would shine the light of Jesus Christ into their lives, that you would open up their eyes, that you would open up their hearts, that you would help them, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amazing grace. We sing that song. I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. Help them to see, Father. Help them to see. Open their eyes to salvation, to Jesus, to the truth. In the same way that your Father in heaven is not wanting any of these little ones to perish, this is a good and pleasing for our God and Savior, who wants everyone to be saved and to come into a knowledge of the truth. Lord, show them the truth, that you are the way, the truth, and the life, that no one comes to the Father but through you. The Lord is not slow to keeping his promise, as some would understand slowness. Instead, he is patient with you, not wanting anyone to perish, but for everyone to come to repentance. Bring those that I've come into contact with over the years to repentance. Lord, those who they've been in contact with to repentance. Touch all of us, Lord, in a mighty way. Bring us to salvation. The eye is the lamp of the body. If your eye is healthy, then your whole body will be full of light. Open our eyes. Take the veil off. Make our eyes healthy so that we can not only hear the truth, but we can see the truth of Jesus Christ. He himself bore our sins on the cross so we might die to sin and live for righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed. The Lord gives sight to the blind. The Lord lifts up those who bow down. The Lord loves the righteous. He watches over the foreigner and maintains the fatherless and the widow, but he frustrates the ways of the wicked. Lord, open the eyes of the blind. Open them to the truth of Jesus Christ. All those on my list who don't know you, Lord, open their hearts, open their lives. Show them the truth in Jesus' name. Turn my eyes away from worthless things. Help me to remember what's worth and worthless. Preserve my life according to your word. Let the light shine out of the darkness. May the light shine in the darkness and in the face of darkness. Lord, I thank you. And Father, as I close out today, Lord, I pray that you would help us to surrender to you today. Surrender our hearts and our lives. It says in your word in James that if we draw near to you, you will draw near to us. So thank you, Lord, for helping me to draw near to you today. Thank you to those who have stood with me in this prayer today. As we prayed your scriptures, as we prayed your verses, Lord, it says in your word that there's power in that. Lord, I pray for power in those people who I've prayed for, that you will help them, Lord, that you will help their churches, that you will help their lives, Lord, that you will bring peace and comfort, that you will bring salvation, that you will bring blessing, that you will bring truth, that you will bring love, and you will take care of all their needs according to your riches and glory. So, Father, I surrender all these things to you today. I surrender my heart and I surrender my love of who you are. I stand in you. You are my God. May your blood cover us and touch us in a mighty way today. May the cross of Christ be strong in our hearts. And may we walk in you. And Father, thank you, Lord, for those who have come to listen today. I give you praise and I thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you so much for coming and praying with me today. I know that I just get in the Lord, and we're over 40 minutes now, and I thank you, Lord. I thank you so much for coming with me and connecting with the Lord. I just get into the moment, but I wanted to show you about praying in scriptures, praying in verses, and the power that there is in the Bible. And there's gonna be a little teaching right after this. So I thank you so much for joining me, and God bless you. And I hope you stay safe out there and have a wonderful day in Christ, and stay within his holiness. I hope that you will heal wholly as you grow to be more holy in him.
This is just a short teaching for you. I'd like to thank you for joining me in this prayer time today. And I just want to let you know your prayers are extremely powerful. When you pray to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords and to the Lion of Judah, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world, when you pray to him, amazing things can take place. But there's something that's even more powerful than your prayers, and that is prayer through the scriptures. And the scriptures are extremely, extremely powerful. When you pray scripture, amazing things can take place. I want to read to you a scripture right now. It's in Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12.
For the word of God is living and active, and sharper than any two-edged sword, and piercing as far as the division of soul and spirit, of both joints and marrow, and able to judge the thoughts and intentions of the heart.
So with that in mind, Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12, it says that the word is active. I also want to look at
Isaiah chapter 55, verses 10 through 11.
For as the rain and the snow come down from heaven, and do not return there without watering the earth, and making it bare and sprout, and furnishing seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so will my word be which goes forth from my mouth. It will not return to me empty without accomplishing what I desire, and without succeeding in the matter for which I sent it.
So it's really important to understand that Jesus is the King of Kings. He's the Lord of Lords. He came to this earth. He can relate to what we have gone through in life. He can understand what we've gone through in life. He's an amazing, an awesome God. He's a wonderful and amazing God. But the best part is he can relate to you. He wept when his friend Lazarus died. He had anxiety in the Garden of Eden. He was sick throughout his life sometimes. All the things that we experience, he experienced as well, which is pretty amazing. So prayer is such an amazing thing. Going to God and being able to talk to him directly is an amazing thing, but something even more powerful than talking to God, is talking to God using the scriptures, talking to God using the Bible, using these verses, because it is alive, it is active, it is powerful, and using the word to be able to teach, using the word to be able to pray on behalf of someone is an amazing thing. So I just wanted to give you a little bit of extra stuff in your arsenal, because we do have the armor of God. It says in Ephesians, we have the breastplate of righteousness. We have the feet that bring the gospel of peace. We have the shield of faith, but we also have the one attacking weapon, which is the sword of the Spirit. When Jesus was in the desert in Matthew 4, he went against the devil, and the devil went against him, and he just used the Holy Spirit, and then he quoted scripture to the devil. A lot of people don't realize he quoted Deuteronomy to the devil. Now, if Jesus, when he prays or when he goes against the enemy, uses scripture, doesn't that tell us that we should use scripture in our prayers as well? That scripture is a powerful tool, that we should be memorizing scripture, and that we should be using it in our prayers. So this is just something that gets you thinking. It's an amazing thing that you pray. You know, when you talk to the Lord, it's an amazing thing. When you give thanks and you praise him, when you do amazing things for him, you know, it's just wonderful to be able to do that for Jesus. And to be able to go to our God and be able to pray on somebody's behalf, to be able to be healed or to be helped. But using scripture is even more powerful, a more powerful tool, a more powerful weapon. And it talks about it throughout this. So my encouragement to you as we close out this video is that use scripture. Use the word of God in your prayer time. Use it when people are hurting that they need healing. Use it when people need blessed. Use it as a way to pray for people to come to know Jesus as their Lord and Savior. There's so many different ways that we can use scripture to be able to pray. And a lot of times we miss out on this resource. So thank you so much for praying with me today. I really appreciate it. Thank you for allowing me to come into your home today through Juniper Tree Ministries. And the JTP would like to say, God bless you. And I always close out by saying that the word can heal you to be more wholly healed, to be holy. God bless you.